Jen here with a YA book review for you of Three Dark Crowns by Kendare Blake. This book has been out for a little while, and the second book is called One Dark Throne. And I recently saw that there is going to be a third and fourth book. I'm not sure, since I haven't read One Dark Throne yet, if the book, like if the two books kind of stand alone and like end nicely, and then if three and four is kind of just going to be considered separate. For me, this book was 3 stars, kind of like a solid 3. The writing style was interesting. The sentences were very short and clipped and kind of succinct. I think that's how you say that word. And the perspective kind of rotates between each of the queens. Arisno, not sure if that's how it's pronounced, who is the naturalist queen, Mirabella, who is the elemental queen, and then Catherine, who is the poisoner queen. And so the premise of the story is that there are 3 triplets born to the queen, and then like that queen, like their parents kind of magically disappear. And then there, each of the queens, the midwife and their mother identifies each of their 3 talents. And then based on the talent, they're moved to an island where they're kind of like fostered, and their gift is like, I can't even think of the word because I worked all day, so my brain is like, their gift is foster, we'll just say as well. So basically, that's the general premise, and then there comes a point, and the reason I'm struggling to explain this also is because I found the book really confusing. And I think that just happens sometimes with fantasy and science fiction, when you have a lot of things that become like made up words, made up places, made up occupations, made up ceremonies, made up festivals, made up everything. So there becomes a ceremony where each of the girls showcases their gift, and a lot of rumor is spreading because Mirabella's gift is exceptionally strong, but Catherine and Arisno do not have strong gifts. Their gifts are very weak. And I also found it confusing because not only is there this festival where they showcase their talents, then after the festival, there's this thing where these mainland boys come, and they are called suitors, and there's like one of them is trying to become the king consort so that he can, which is just like a figurehead and like a piece between the islands and the mainland kind of. And then like on top of that, there's the Ascension year, and before the Beltane festival, it starts with the hunt, which is like the naturalist thing. And then there's, I don't know, it's just really confusing, I guess. Then on top of these islands and these talents, then there's the mainland, and mainland people are called mainlanders. And then there's something called low magic on top of these like 3 predominant talents, and low magic is like old blood magic, like witchcraft kind of, I guess you could say, even though it's not referred to as that, just for lack of a better comparison. Then on top of that, there are goddesses, or the goddess, who is like the island itself and who endows the queens with their powers. And then there is the temple, which has priestesses that run it, and the priestesses have kind of aligned with Mirabella because she looks so strong, and they haven't been have a lot of strength in a long time. And then the poisoners kind of dominate something called the Black Council, because the poisoners have been in power for a long time. And there's just, all of it's just really confusing. And it, for me, there's so much that it bogs the story down. This book like was easy to read when I read it, but when I wasn't reading it, I didn't find myself wanting to, you know, pick it up like, ooh, I can't wait to read later today and see what happens. I was just like, eh, I'd rather go to sleep tonight. So the last 100 pages I read last night, and they were a lot better. They were also a lot shorter. And so it made for a quick read. And there was a twist at the end, but I had spoiled myself by looking at the page numbers, so I knew that. And then I had spoiled myself on top of it by seeing the announcement for the third book, so I know who wins the whole darn thing. How she wins, I don't know, but I know who ultimately becomes queen already. I found Mirabella kind of annoying. I liked her at first, and I did not like Catherine very much, because really I just find this whole story incredibly morbid, because there's things like if they don't find, like when the triplets are born, if not only are they separated, but if they're born and one's power seems dominant, they like drown the others, and I find that incredibly morbid, and just the fact that they have to kill each other, and you know, they're trying to find a way, to ensure that Mirabella wins, the priestesses are, but then Catherine's family and Arasno's family are trying to find a way to help them to survive, because ultimately they have to kill each other, and whichever queen is like the last one standing is the one who wins. And so now at the end of the story, they're entering something called the Ascension Year, and that is the year that the queens have to basically kill each other. I just don't know, like, I'm gonna read the next book. I doubt, unless the next book's really good, that I'll read the third and fourth one. I'm not even sure. Like, I was really encouraged to read this book, by a friend and another, person in the bookish community on Bookstagram encouraged me to read it. And then another friend also really enjoyed it. And I just, like, they all said the second book is way better. But there's just, one, it's morbid, which I don't really care for, and two, there's a lot going on. Like, you ever hear the saying, less is more? I think sometimes that's true, even when it comes to books, is that, like, why are you making things, like, so complicated? I don't, like, why are there essentially three different political entities, you know, slash religious entities, and I don't know. And I feel like the naturalist talent and the elemental talent are kind of similar, because one, they get a familiar, which is an animal like companion that's an extension of you. Speaking of animal companions, my animal companion, my familiar, has entered the room. And then the elemental is like controlling fire and water and all that kind of stuff. And like, they're kind of similar, but they're not. But I feel like they could have been lumped into something together, because Poisoner is just like so different compared to those two. So I feel like maybe Naturalist and Elemental should have been lumped together, and then maybe a third talent should have been created instead. I'm not sure what the third talent would be, but I just think that, I don't know. Like, they're too similar, and then Poisoner is just like really out there, so it's a little bit different. So you can tell from this review that I didn't really enjoy this book. It was okay for a long time. I said I wasn't gonna probably read the second one, but it does kind of end on a cliffhanger, and I really like Arasno and her friend slash, we'll just call her, they're not like in a relationship yet, but his name is Billy, and I really like him, and I kind of want to see what happens between the two of them. There are a lot of annoying characters in here. Like, Mirabella acts super annoying, and this character Joseph acts super annoying, and Jewel's mother, which is Arasno's foster mother, is really annoying. There's just, I mean, I guess like in real life you have annoying people, but like, I don't know. Maybe it's just me. So I know a lot of people who like this series, if that's helpful. So maybe you might want to give it a try to form your own opinion. This book actually came from another friend who started it and lost interest, so she sent it to me to read. So I don't know if that's helpful information as well. It sounds super long. It's almost 400 pages. I don't know. I'm gonna read the second book, so maybe that review might actually affect this review, possibly, depending on how the plot lines that aren't finished, which is pretty much all of them, and you can kind of see where maybe some of them might go, but I did enjoy the twists at the end, and I don't know, I don't know if I would have saw it coming if I hadn't spoiled myself, and I didn't spoil myself on purpose, which if you follow my channel, you know that I sometimes do, and this video has gotten really long and rambling, because I just got home from work and I haven't had dinner yet, I haven't exercised or anything. And because my feelings to this book are kind of bleh. So yeah, for me, this is like a 3-star book. It's okay. I did not like it, but I didn't really like it or love it. So I'm willing to see what happens in the next book and then form an opinion from there as to whether I want to read the 3 and 4 when they are released. Right now I'm going to say no, but never say never. So that is my review for Three Dark Crowns. In the meanwhile, happy reading.